are facial and sometimes lingual slots in dentin caused by toothbrush abrasion? Look at these so-called abfractions. And you'll see I put cord in, that's why the tissue is blanched, and I pushed the gingiva down, and right at the dentinal enamel junction, these slots have occurred. They were subgingival before I put that cord in. What causes these? The person who has been most instrumental in identifying so-called abfractions has now broadened the overall orientation of it to include three factors: stress, friction, and biocorrosion. Now, I'm going to divide these out for a minute and just let you think about what stress is and what friction is and what biocorrosion is. In other words, it was originally thought of to be only a bending of the tooth back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, much like you would bend a wire or a copper wire, where if you stressed it enough going back and forth, what would it do? It would cavitate on one side and be compressed on the other side. That was the initial theory. And John Grippo, a dentist well known in the occlusion area, is the person who has put this now combined factors of three together. Let's look at stress first. Stress is essentially what we initially defined abfraction to be, and that is the back and forth, back and forth, back and forth movement as you move your teeth left and right, left and right, left and right. And you can see the factors that John Grippo has placed into that orientation of stress. You can't avoid that. A clenching bruxism bites straight down, whereas a grinding bruxism is left, right, forward, back. There's always enormous stress on the teeth. What about friction? This is the one some still think causes these slots. How could we have friction such as toothbrush abrasion in a bear? There was actually a study done in the Northeast U.S. some time ago where they found abfractions in bears. And they found abfractions in Aborigines in Australia. They haven't even heard of a toothbrush. But yes, friction must have some orientation toward those slots because you are brushing your teeth with a very abrasive material. It's refined a lot, but you know as well as I, you started out with your teeth fairly irregular and anatomic looking, and all of a sudden they're a slick, smooth surface. What is biocorrosion? One of the major factors there would be GERD. GERD is present in upwards of 50% of people over 50 years of age. They eat Mexican food, Italian food, chocolate, pizza, any kind of spicy thing. They go to bed, flop back on their back, and they're pouring acid into their mouth at just a little over 1 pH. Teeth start to demineralize at about 5, and by 3 pH, they're rapidly losing structure. Now, let's just put all three of those together again, as Grippo suggested. And this would be the mechanism that is postulated to cause these peculiar slots on the facial and occasionally on the lingual of teeth. As you can see, they all overlap. Stress, friction, biocorrosion. They all overlap somewhat. And as this phenomena occurs in the mouth, that may change. You may have stress and friction, and all of a sudden in middle age, the sphincter on your esophagus quits working, and now you got biocorrosion happening. So all through life, this is going to be different. And what it says to you and me is, good luck trying to stop some of those. It would be almost impossible. My feeling about abfractions is if they collect food or if they are unsightly or if they are sensitive, three things, I'm likely to put a restoration in. If none of the above are present, leave them as they are. Thanks for being with us. Join us next week. Don't forget.